Now let's take a look at Android security. Here's an overview of the architecture of Android, which is based on Linux. Android is implemented in the form of a software stack architecture, consisting of a Linux kernel, a runtime environment and corresponding libraries, an application framework, and a set of applications. At the lowest level is the Linux kernel. It provides a level of abstraction between device hardware and the upper layers of the Android software stack. Each application running on the Android device runs its own instance of the Delvik virtual machine. Apps are commonly written in Java and compiled to bytecode of the Java virtual machine, which is then translated to Delvik bytecode. The Delvik executable format is very compact, and it is designed for systems such as smartphones that are constrained in terms of memory and processor speed. By using Delvik, Android can achieve performance and efficiency. The Android core libraries are Java-based libraries for application development. For example, for web browsing, data access and database queries, graphics rendering, and so on. The Android core libraries do not actually perform much of the actual work, and are in fact essentially Java wrappers around a set of C and C++ based libraries. These C and C++ libraries are included to fulfill a wide range of functions, including 2D and 3D graphics rendering, secure socket layer, etc. The application framework is a set of services that collectively form the environment for Android apps to run. The application framework allows apps to be constructed using reusable, interchangeable, and replaceable components. Furthermore, an app can publish its capabilities along with any corresponding data so that they can be found and reused by other apps. At the top of the Android software stack are the apps. These include apps that come with the device, such as Home, Contacts, and Phone, and Browser, and other third-party apps that the user has downloaded after he purchases the device.